Greetings, dear viewers, and welcome to another tutorial on design genius. Today we will be looking into a differential box or a gearbox system. When we talk of differential here, it's a bit different, not like the traditional differential system that we have in vehicles with a spur gear differential that is having three shafts. But in this case it is a bit different. We have two shafts, that is the inlet shaft and the outlet shaft. So looking into it critically, we are going to see that the inlet shaft, we have created a key way which can carry a pulley, of which we can use it to maybe carry out the transmission of power into other systems. And at the level of the inlet shaft, we have a key which has been incorporated on it. And with this system, if I try to maybe rotate it, we are going to see the motion of the out gear shaft. So when we look at this level, we are going to see the rotation. So now for us to see the detailed functioning of this system, I'll be taking you to maybe a drawing where we can see what exactly is happening inside this sum or this casing. Now the aim of this tutorial is for us to see how we can carry out a motion study, and maybe it can also serve for mechanical engineering students, for them to be able to see how they can carry out an assembly. When we talk about assembly, the different ways of maybe blocking our bearings or mounting our bearings in such a system. So now taking you into a diagram without the cover here, I'm going to carry out an exploded view so we can see the different ways in which we have of the system. So now I'm going to pull out the right cover. Here we can see the ring, and we can see the seal. This seal actually helps to prevent maybe dust particles from entering the system, and or as well as preventing the lubricant from leaking out. And on this other end, we have the cover too. And we see that this cover too is not, the function is not only to cover this system, but it also helps us to. Now at the level of our main shaft, we can see the gear itself and the pinion, which brings in the movement, and this movement is now being transmitted by this gear. So now on this gear, actually we have tried to use a shoulder which has been created on the shaft. This shoulder helps to block the gear in rotation, in translation, sorry. And meanwhile in rotation, we have made use of a key which now tries helps also to keep the gear and the shaft in movement. Now on still on this shaft, we have used a nut and a washer. This nut actually helps to block the gear in translation as well. It means at the right side we have a shoulder which blocks the gear in translation. Here's the shoulder, and at the left side we have a nut, and we have created threads on the shaft which carries the nut, and it helps to prevent the gear in translation, that is to the left direction. And now looking at the level of the inlet shaft, we have a ball bearing which helps this shaft to guide it in rotation. Now we have two main bearings here. The first one is the taper ruler bearing at the level of the main shaft, and at the level of the inlet shaft we have the ball bearing. Now if we want to look into the shaft, that is all calculation being done, the types of diameter and the different measurements when it comes to our shaft. Moving up at the level of edit toolbox component, we are going to see the ratio between the gear itself and the pinion. Now, when we look at the level of the pitch diameter, we have as 3.5, and the number of teeth we have 49, and the pinion number of teeth. When we talk of pinion number of teeth, here's the pinion number of teeth is 16, and gear number of teeth is 49. That is giving us a ratio of 16 is to 49. From this ratio, we can see that this system is a reducing system, means the speed entering the system and the output, we have a lower speed. So now, all calculation being done, this is what we have: number of teeth, the keyway, nominal shaft diameter, we have 6 minus 1 over 2. And at this level, I'll be taking you back to our main drain so we can see or we can carry out the motion study. At this level, we are going to make some transparent. We move up at the level of component display, we take a wireframe. Now here we can now see maybe what everything is happening inside, and we'll simply move up to the level of new motion study. And at this point, we are going to assign the shaft, the inlet shaft, as the rotatory part. And looking here, all parameters at the level of a constant speed, I think it is normal. We can leave it at level of constant speed. I think everything is already being set as default, and we simply validate it, and we run the motion, and we can increase our motion time right up to 20 seconds, and we run our motion. Okay, I think at this point in time, we can simply click on play, and we try to visualize what everything is happening inside the system. So now, when we look keenly, we will see that the speed at the level of the inlet shaft, we have a high speed here, and at this level, the speed is a bit lower as compared to what we have this way. So now, this is just confirming the functioning of our system. As I earlier said, it is a reducing system with a ratio of 16 to 49. So at this point in time, if we are going back to our model, and we'll try to look again into some other details. Now, at this level of the inlet shaft, we also as well made use of a seal, which helps us to prevent dust particles from entering into the system. So if we try to pull out the cover here, we can see the seal. And at this end also, we made use of this cover to block the ball bearing at this level from translation movement. So, dear viewers, at this point in time, I thank you for watching. It has been Never Connect on the Keyboard, and I call on you to stay tuned to our YouTube channel for more videos.